الديار وهجروا الدخار طافوا المزية والشعار ولبسوا الرداء والإزار ملبية دعوة الواحد القهار. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله صاحب الوجه الأنور والجبين الأزهر والقلب الأطهر فصلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين. الله أكبر الله أكبر. Brothers and sisters, عيد مبارك وكل عام وأنتم بخير. There is no more symbolic act of worship in Islam than the pillar of Hajj. All the actions of Hajj are so symbolic, and every single action symbolizes something. But the Hajj itself represents a very important meaning for the Muslims and for the whole world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never mentioned the word an-nafs, people, as much as he did in Surah Al-Hajj, starting Ya Ayyuhan Nas, that will be second after Surah An-Nas. But the word an-nafs was mentioned in Surah Al-Hajj the most in the whole Quran. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Sayyidina Ibrahim, and you can understand that Ibrahim alayhi salam to go for Hajj, he didn't ask him to say, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, come for Hajj. He said, Wa'adhdhin fil nasi bil Hajj. For people, everyone, for Hajj. So the call, the announcement of the Islam is for people. Brothers and sisters, as soon as you read, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. You immediately realize that you, Lord Allah, is the Lord of everyone. Allah never called himself the Lord of Arab, or the Lord of Muslims, or he's blessed with God who never believes. Allah is the Lord of the worlds. Every single creature is his creature. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is announcing himself the Lord, the God of the world, the Lord of the world. And when he said Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his message, he sent him as mercy for the worlds. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was it sent for certain tribe? Or was it sent for certain people? Was it sent for the Arab? He was sent for everyone in the world. And the message that that messenger carried was also delivered to the world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always says, Ya ayyuhal nas. Allah will never say the Quran, Ya ayyuhal Arab, Ya ayyuhal Muslimin, Ya ayyuhal Quraysh. Allah has always said, Ya ayyuhal nas. Especially in the Mecca era of the Quran, I will talk to the al-insan or al-nas. With this understanding of Islam, that our Lord, our God is the God of the worlds, our messenger is the messenger of the worlds, and the Quran, the deen, has been for everyone. What do you expect from the Islam bearers and Islam carriers? Islam is the only deen, is the only regime in the world, has established what we call the universal personality. Islam has brought up with its world personal, universal personalities. Every one of the Sahaba was enough to go to any place in the world with the leader of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was preparing his companion to become everyone then a universal personality. And he has established that from when announcing the da'wah, and Jahru bil da'wah, when he stood in Mecca, and he said, I want you to say one word, Ul Kalima. If you say it, the whole world will fall. Malakum, da'latakum biha al-arab, wa malakum biha al-alam. The da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was meant to cover the whole world, because it's the deed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With such a personality, when the Islam expects every single Muslim to be a universal personality, that it is so much work to be done before that. Every single Muslim has to expand himself and to elevate his soul, to come out of these limitations that we have put on ourselves as human beings from day one. You have to come out of yourself and expand yourself from your individuality to be out, extended out to your community, to your country. You have to serve to the whole world. If the Muslim carries his mentality, a tribal thinking, that is not qualified, is not qualified to be a personality. If you believe that, I only consider within these borders that was actually drawn by Salish people, you're not qualified to be the way Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is expecting you to be. If you are the person who believed in the tribal thinking, or the family thinking, or only the country affairs, or only focusing on himself, you're not qualified. Even worse than that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was asked about discrimination and type of thinking, and any kind of consulia, he said, da'uha fina rutina. Throw it. Toss it, throw it away, it stinks. These limitations are so stinks for Muslims. You as a Muslim, like every Sahaba, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has brought up, they were absolutely universal people. And the best example I can present to you now is one Adha nation, one of the main Sahaba, they're all great. But one of the Amat in Nas, one of the public. He is a perfect example for the idea of to be a universal personality. Shasiya Aliya, this is what you are. How do you come that? With what you carry in your heart and in your mind and deliver it to people. You are a messenger, bearer, carrier, salah, and you have a mission in this life. The Ibn Mu'amir radiallahu anhu in the Battle of Al-Qadisiyah, when the Muslimin, in the era of Umar Khattab radiallahu anhu, approached Persia. And the supreme commander of the Persian army was Rustam. And this Rustam, of course, he wasn't like anyone. In order to reach Rustam, you have to walk at least 100 or 150 or 80 meters on the red carpet before you reach Rustam. So he was so concerned about the Muslims to reach there. So he asked, he sent a message that I need someone to talk to me before we start the war. So Sayyidina Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, we can send him a delegation. The Prophet Muhammad, the ordinary man, the ordinary Muslim, he said, we're not going to do that. Just send me by myself and I don't want to stand him. The Prophet Muhammad, the ordinary Muslim, but he was brought by Allah, by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He knows his message. He was a universal personality. As soon as he reached Rustam, the whole story, so Rustam asked him a question. What brought you out? الَّذِي جَابِكُمْ. What are you doing here? You the Arabs, you nothing. We used to assign you kings. We are the decision maker for you, Arab tribes. What has changed you? You know what the Prophet Muhammad said? Did he say we want your money? We want your crown? We want to rule you? It wasn't the message. He said, Jibna. Jibna. نخرج العبادة من عبادة العباد إلى عبادة رب العباد ومن جو الأديان إلى عبد الإسلام ومن تريد الدنيا لا سعد الدنيا ولا الآخرة. He said the message, the universal message that he gave out there. He said we came out to bring people, to stop people from worshiping people in order to worship the Lord of the people. We came here to take people out from the injustice of every regime, because deen means regime, by the way, doesn't mean religion. Takes people out of the injustice of every other regime, bring them in the justice of Islam. And we take the people out, so the people, we didn't say the Arab, we didn't say any Mashallah, the people who are the world, they were taking people out of the hardship of this dunya to the richness, to the fullness of this dunya and hereafter. And that was the message from an ordinary Muslim who knows what he's doing in this life. He knows his message, he understands his role in this life. Brothers and sisters, if you want to be a proper Muslim, you have to elevate your way of thinking and expand your feeling and concerns to cover the world. You have to be a universal personality. We cannot keep just talking about our own affairs, which is so narrow. There have to be so much self-centered sometimes. If you go to Hajj, you will see how universal Islam is, and this is so symbolic. Everybody from everywhere, from every language of the world, from every language, every skin color, worshiping one God. They all say, Ya Allah, there's no other one. When you go to Hajj, you realize the meaning of Wa inna hadhihi ummatukum wahida. Umma wahida, that has expanded, inshallah, in what? In 150 years. That has expanded to Spain in 150 years, down to South Africa in probably 50-60 years. Muslims will say never again, only of themselves. We have to expand, we have to elevate our souls and our thinking to cover the whole world and to establish the examples that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had established from the beginning. On the top of that, being a universal personality, it means also humanitarian personality. We're not conquerors. We don't want to take anything from anyone. We just want to deliver the deed of Allah in a personal, in a humanitarian way where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expresses us to do. At the beginning, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala read the Quran of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first few words was Iqra, read in the name of your Lord. Al-Insan. If you read this surah, this surah called Al-Insan, it's all about Al-Insan. So would you carry as a universal personality, would you carry this message to the others? You carry it because you are Insan. And you can say there's so much about humanity. I have a perfect example for that. How the Muslims, how our ancestors felt toward the others, especially when they are in power. Sulaiman al-Qanuni, rahimahullah. Sulaiman, the greatest Ottoman, Sultan, or Khalifa, the Magnificent. They called in English Sulaiman the Magnificent. When he used to ride with a man, or when they make a decision, he used to say, إِنَّهُ لِسُلَيْمَانَ وَإِنَّهُ سُلَيْهِ رَحْمَنَ رَحِيمٌ. He is Sulaiman of his God. One day, and that was in the 16th century, Sulaiman, his influences were covering Europe, Asia, Africa, the whole world. One day, a report came to him saying that in France, they're actually innovating something different. What was that? They're actually building houses for dancing. As in France. For him, France was one of his states, one of his provinces, Wilaya of France, that before. Immediately, whatsoever they did, why would he care? They're not Muslims. Or just he is a universal personality. And he's a humanitarian personality. He wrote a letter back to the King of France. He said, I hear you're doing something so bad in Zania. Something so bad for humanity. A bad habit you're innovating for Al Bashariya, for humanity. And I'm commanding you to start now. 24 hours, every dancing house was closed in France. Yes, brothers and sisters, you have this possibility. Will not go to Israel and family, or within your authority, within your knowledge, as much as you can expand yourself, you know you are a universal personality. And probably you have more chance than anyone else because you are Canada. Islam has been never been meant to be limited. Islam has elevated every form to actually cross the borders of the earth and the heavens. استطعتم أن تنفذوا من أقطار السماوات والأرض فانفذوا. People always have misunderstood this ayah that says Allah shall be cancelled because you cannot do. Allah is telling you that Allah is inviting you to do that. Allah is inviting you to penetrate the borders of the earth and the heavens. The only civilization in the world that has introduced what we call encyclopedic scientists is the Islamic civilization. And we're not most of you. Because they were able to expand themselves in every field and every aspect. You mention one alim and his alim in astrology, his alim in mathematics, his alim in geography, his alim in linguistics, his alim, and then he's a doctor. It's amazing. There's no other civilization has achieved such a personality other than the Islamic personality. So, brothers and sisters, when you attach a symbolic that symbolizes the meaning of being universal personality, you will realize from day one that people having a bad power, there are no differences, no limitations, no borders. The king is just like the ordinary person having the same thing. You want to unite them because they're going back to their humanity. They're going back, they put everything down and going back to their humanity. When they go around the Kaaba, they put line with Allah's words back to their humanity. When they go to Arafat and go crying and calling and praying for one Lord, for one God, they're back to their humanity. Back to the point, to the starting point, by the sunset of that day, Allah says, you're back to the day you were born. Your place is not again. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this week inspire us to be a universal person and expand ourselves, to integrate ourselves and overcome all these small affairs to the bigger affairs that when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can say, Ya Allah, I have delivered even one word from your message. أقول ما أسمع الله سبحانه وتعالى
السلام عليكم. الجمعة today, inshallah, is going to be a public address. So,
in the Middle East, wherever they are, Pakistan, Yemen, Iraq, about your house in Myanmar who have been suffering under the line because of the same La ilaha illallah. Take a moment and think about this, brothers and sisters, and see what we can do just to get yourself out of inside yourself and expand yourself. We are all brothers, Maskatu Bilimani Ihwana. Today is a perfect example for being brothers. Today is a perfect example for being one woman. We all came from different places, but we all have to say that we are in the Lord to pray for one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, I wish this morning to be Salat Jum'ah in the laboratory. Salat Eid doesn't cancel Salat Jum'ah, but it's free, it's absolutely optional for those who claim that Eid not to be a Jum'ah, but the Jum'ah has never been cancelled. And but in the third day, that has to be established as well, regardless whether people have attained the Eid or not. The Jum'ah is not cancelled, this has to be established. But you, because you attended the Jum'ah of the Eid, you have the option to go to Jum'ah or not to go to Jum'ah. Of course, I say the Imam, I don't believe the Imam of a Muslim, that means he's the Muslim leaders, which we will have that day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala substituted us from all these leaders from one leader to what the Muslim leader of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma khadiyu kumina wa rukumina. All the Muslimina wa Muslimina. Wa ta'ala imuhum wa rukumina. Allahumma la ta'ala fi hadhi al-ibhi dhaka illa ghafarta. Wa la dhala illa hadayka. Wa la marida illa shafiqa. Wa la musafira illa bi khayri illa hadihi wa dhaka. Wa la talib ilmi illa ajadu wa rasidu ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma ij'alna hudan lil mahtadin. La dhalin wa la mudallin. Allahumma farrij an ummati Muhammad fi kulli makan ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma rafa'a anha li Muhammad al-jud wa al-iman. Wa ij'alna min ibadika ar-rashidin. Ya Allah, this day of Eid, kullu 'amin wa rabbika khair.